The most critical needs of a human being is to know if they matter, whether they are loved, whether they are valued, and whether they are significant. When these needs are ignored, we end up looking for it in different places, which finally brings us to a point of despair and desolation. This points us to the question of our day. Do I matter? The Bible says we are loved, we are secure, and significant. Reading from Scripture, John chapter 3, verse 16. For God so greatly loved and dearly prized the world that He even gave His one and only begotten Son, so that whoever believes and trusts in Him as Savior shall not perish, but have eternal life. This is a familiar verse, but it holds the grand truth of how much we matter to God. As humans, we are driven to meet each of our needs through our relationships or through different other things we engage in. We crave to be loved in our earthly relationships. We look for security in our money, in our possessions, and we hope to find significance in our work, in our talents, or in our positions. But the Bible talks about all these things as temporal and fading and not something that we can put our hope and our trust in. For example, on a hot day, our thirst is never satiated. No matter how much we drink, we would like to have more and more. In the same way, our craving for love, security, and significance is never satiated. We look for it in better people, better jobs, more success, better circumstances, but none of this truly satiates. The only remedy for this search is seen in our scripture verse today. During creation, when God created Adam and Eve, He put these attributes in the heart of Adam and Eve, where they were perfectly loved, where they were perfectly valued, and where they were perfectly secure. When sin came in, they lost these inherent attributes of being loved, of being secure, and valued due to their separation from God. And thus began the search, and they felt the need to look for this in all different places. So what man lost, God came back to restore through Jesus. You are loved. God loves and prizes you greatly, that He did the most that He could do by sending His Son, Jesus Christ, because He wanted to share His eternity with you. You are secure. He gives you a place to always belong and to be secure, a place of abundance where there is no lack, which we know as eternity. He didn't want you to be separated from Him, so that He called you into a relationship with Him. So you have a place of belonging and security even now in your daily fellowship and communion with the Lord Jesus Christ. And lastly, you are significant. You are so valued and important that He gave His one and only Son. Think about this. If you were given something that was valuable or of utmost price by someone, what would that mean? It would mean you were special and you were significant to them. Remember that you are so loved, you're so valued and significant that God the Father gave His Son to die in your place. Let's pray. Father God, we thank You for loving us. We thank You for making us secure. We thank You for making us significant. Because of what You did on the cross, we know that You love us, that You keep us secure, and that You have placed such a high value on us that You did not want eternity without us. Help us, Master, to be able to look in awe at what You did for us. Thank You, because we matter to You. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Thank you for tuning in to Living Supernaturally. For more resources to strengthen your spiritual walk, please visit apcwo.org.